Have you been told you need neck surgery? Let me explain what the patient can expect from an anterior cervical discectomy infusion, or commonly referred to as the ACDF. We'll begin with breaking down the name, anterior cervical discectomy infusion. Anterior refers to the direction which the surgeon approaches the patient's body, and cervical refers to the location where the surgery is conducted. In other words, the surgeon makes an incision in the front or anterior neck or cervical area. The incision is not just skin deep. Care is taken to safely dissect between the different muscle planes and avoid damage to other important structures. The esophagus, trachea, and major arteries and veins are carefully retracted, allowing the surgeon to visualize the targeted spine area. Discectomy refers to the removal of herniated disc material. Once the surgeon has reached the bones of the neck and located the target disc, the disc material is removed. Without the pressure from the herniated disc, the surrounding tissues, such as the thecal sac, spinal nerves, and spinal cord, are no longer irritated. Any compressing bone spurs are also removed at this stage. Now, fusion, as the name implies, refers to the formation of a single bone from what was originally two vertebrae. The bone edges are scraped clear of soft tissue and contoured appropriately to accept the bone graft or cage that's placed into the empty space that contained the removed disc. The bone or cage then heals together to complete the fusion process. Care must be taken to select the appropriate sized graft or cage to fit into the disc space. Usually, a combination of plates and screws provides stability while the bone grows into the graft. Upon graft completion, the surgeon returns all the structures to their proper place and the incision is closed. A cervical collar may be recommended depending on the patient and the intensity of the procedure. As expected, certain activities may be restricted while your body recovers from the operation. Specific questions and individual concerns should be discussed with your surgeon. Why should I get an anterior cervical discectomy infusion? It is the preferred surgical intervention for symptomatic cervical spine herniations or bone spurs that compress the spinal cord or nerves. The most well-studied and well-established causes for ACDF are radiculopathy and myelopathy. Those with radiculopathy caused from a pinched nerve are often able to improve with non-surgical treatment. One study shows that most patients show improvement in their symptoms without surgery within 4 to 6 months. The presence of a significant spinal cord compression or myelopathy can be a reason for pursuing surgery. As emphasized in my prior videos, ACDF should only be considered when all non-surgical or conservative treatments have been exhausted. What are the concerns? Upon the surgeon's confirmation of the diagnosis by clinical findings, a surgical intervention should be considered. Severe symptoms of myelopathy are more than just numbness and radiating pains in the dermatomal distribution. If there are severe weaknesses of the legs or inability to control your bladder and bowels, you must be evaluated immediately. What are the current research? Studies have shown the efficacy of an alternative surgery, which is the cervical disc arthroplasty or disc replacement procedure. It may preserve cervical motion and potentially reduce the risk of adjacent segment degeneration compared to standard anterior cervical discectomy infusion. Additionally, non-fusion alternatives are available and are preferred in some scenarios. Current research is being aimed at improving fusion with the use of 3D printing, the goal being to improve patient outcomes. For a long time, ACDF has and still remains a standard surgical intervention for managing symptomatic disc herniations. Despite boasting a relatively high success rate and low complication rate, it still has room for improvement. New technological advances may result in even better surgical techniques and better patient outcomes. I hope this video broadened your understanding of ACDF. Until next time, this is Dr. John Shemp.